नमस्कार, आई एम आनंद एंड यू आर वॉचिंग जॉइन फॉर एडुकेशन। इन दिस क्लास आई एम गोइंग टू सॉल्व द क्वेश्चंस ऑफ मिसलेनियस एक्सरसाइज। ऑल क्वेश्चंस ऑफ दिस एक्सरसाइज रिलेटेड टू द स्ट्रेट लाइन। लेट्स सी द क्वेश्चन नंबर वन। नाउ आई एम गोइंग टू रीड द क्वेश्चन। फाइंड द वैल्यू ऑफ के फॉर विच द लाइन k माइनस 3x माइनस 4 माइनस k स्क्वायर y प्लस k स्क्वायर माइनस 7k प्लस 6 इक्वल टू 0 ईच। देर आर थ्री ऑप्शंस ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चंस। पैरेलल टू द x एक्सिस, ऑप्शन बी पैरेलल टू द y एक्सिस, ऑप्शन सी पासिंग थ्रू द ओरिजिन। आंसर्स ऑफ ऑल क्वेश्चंस आर ऑलरेडी प्रिपेयर्ड इन द PDF फॉर्म। लेट्स सी आंसर ऑफ दिस क्वेश्चन। द गिवन इक्वेशन ऑफ द लाइन इज k माइनस 3x माइनस 4 माइनस k स्क्वायर y प्लस k स्क्वायर माइनस 7k प्लस 6 इक्वल टू 0। सपोज दिस इज द इक्वेशन नंबर 1। इफ द गिवन लाइन is parallel to the x-axis, then slope of the line equal to slope of the x-axis. The given line can be written as 4 minus k square y equal to k minus 3x plus k square minus 7k plus 6. So this part moves in the right hand side of 0, then we get this one. So y equal to here k minus 3 by 4 minus k square x plus k square minus 7k plus 6 by 4 minus k square. So this is in the form of y equal to mx plus c. So the slope of this equation will be k minus 3 by 4 minus k square, slope of the line. Hope that there is no problem to understand up to this step. Slope of the x-axis equal to 0 according to the question. So k minus 3 by 4 minus k square equal to 0. When 4 minus k square multiplied by 0, then in the left hand side we have k minus 3 equal to 0. When minus 3 moves in the right hand side of the 0, then we get k equal to 3. Thus, if the given line is parallel to the x axis, then the value of k is 3. Let's see the B part of this question. If the given line is parallel to the y-axis, it's vertical, or it is vertical, hence its slope will be undefined. The slope of the given line is k minus 3 by 4 minus k square. Now k minus 3 by 4 minus k square is undefined. Then denominator of this fraction will be 0. So 4 minus k square equal to 0. So this one will be k square equal to 4. Therefore k equal to 4 over root. So square root of 4 is plus minus 2. Thus, if the given line is parallel to the y-axis, then value of k is plus minus 2. Let's see the C section of this question. If the given line is passing through the origin, then the point 0, 0 satisfy the given equation. So when x equal to 0 and y equal to 0, these parts will be 0. सो के स्क्वायर माइनस सेवन के प्लस सिक्स इक्वल टू जीरो. सो वी स्प्लिट द मिडल टर्म के स्क्वायर माइनस सिक्स के माइनस के प्लस सिक्स इक्वल टू जीरो. सो द फैक्टोराइजेशन ऑफ दिस वन इज के माइनस सिक्स इंटू के माइनस वन, देयर फोर के इक्वल टू वन और सिक्स. Thus, if the given line is passing through the origin, then the value of k is either 1 or 6. Hope that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. Let's see the next question. This is the question number 2. I am going to read the question number 2. Find the equations of the lines which cut off intercepts on the axis whose sum and product are 1 and minus 6 respectively. Let's see the answer or solution of this question. Let the intercept cut by the given line on the x-axis be A and B. It is given that according to the question, sum of the intercept A plus B is 1 and the product of the intercept A into B is minus 6. On solving equation 1 and 2, we obtain A equal to 3 and B equal to minus 2, or A equal to minus 2 or B equal to 3. Hope that there is no problem to understand up to this step. It is known that the equation of the line whose intercepts on the axis are A and B. We recall the intercept form of a straight line, which is x by A plus y by B equal to 1. So we take the LCM AB, then we get BX plus AY by AB equal to 1. So BX plus AY, and we move AB in the left hand side, then this one will be minus AB, and in the right hand side we have 0. Hope that there is no problem to understand up to this step. Now consider these two as case wise. So in case 1, when A equal to 3 and B equal to minus 2, now putting the value of A and B here, then we get minus 2x plus 3y plus 6 equal to 0. So 2x minus 3y equal to 6. So this part move in the right hand side. Case 2, A equal to minus 2 and B equal to 3. Now putting the value of A and B, then we get this one. So this part move in the right hand side, then we get minus 3x plus 2y equal to 6. Thus the required equation of the lines are 2x minus 3y equal to 6 and minus 3x plus 2y equal to 6. Hope that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. Let's see the next question. This is the question number 3. What are the points on the y-axis whose distance from the line, the equation of the straight line which is in the intercept form, is x by 3 plus y by 4 equal to 1 is 4 units. Let AB be the point on the y axis. So 0 be the point on the y axis whose distance from the line is 4 units. The given line can be written as 4x plus 3y, so this is the 12 with LCM, then we get 4x plus 3y equal to 12. When 12 move in the left hand side, then we get minus 12, and in the right hand side we get 0. So this is the equation number 1. On comparing equation 1 to the general equation, this is the general equation of a straight line, we obtain a equal to 4, b equal to 3, and c equal to minus 12. Now we recall, it is known that perpendicular distance d of a line ax plus by plus c equal to 0 from a point. The coordinate of the point is x1, y1 given by, so d equal to, we put the value of x and y as x1 and y1. So here, therefore 0b is the point on y-axis whose distance from this one is 4. So this is the 4, and 4 into 0, this is the x, and this is the y. 3 into b, and this is the c equal to minus 12 by a square plus b square. Here a equal to 4 and b equal to 3, so 4 a square plus 3 a square over root. So here will be 3b minus 12 by 5. 4 a square equal to 16, 3 a square equal to 9, 16 plus 9 equal to 25, and the a square root of 25 is 5. After the cross multiplication, we get here 4 into 5 equal to 20. In the right hand side, we have absolute value of 3b minus 12. So this one will be plus minus. When we remove absolute, then plus minus 3b minus 12. One time we take plus, second time we take minus. In each time, after the calculation, which is very easy, we get b equal to 32/3, and in the second case b equal to minus 8/3. Thus the equation or the required points are 0 b, so 0 32/3 and 0 minus 8/3. Hope that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. Let's see the question number 4. Now I am going to read the question number 4. Find the perpendicular distance from the origin to the line joining the points cos theta, sin theta, and cos phi, sin phi. Let's see the answer or solution of this question. The equation of the line joining the point cos theta, sin theta, and cos phi, sin phi is given by y minus y1, y2 minus y1 by x2 minus x1 into x minus x1. So here x1, y1, this is the x1. This is the y1, this is the x2, and this is the y2. So hope that there is no problem to understand up to this step. So y cos phi minus cos theta, when this one is multiplied by this one, then we get this one. So this is very easy. Hope that there is no problem to understand. When this one multiplied by this one, then we get this one. X into sin phi minus sin theta minus cos theta sin phi minus sin theta. After the simple calculation, we get this step. So x sin theta minus sin phi plus y cos phi minus cos theta plus cos theta into sin phi माइनस कॉस थीटा इंटू साइन थीटा माइनस साइन थीटा इंटू साइन फाई प्लस साइन थीटा इंटू कॉस थीटा. सो दिस वन कैंसल्ड आउट. साइन थीटा कॉस फाई कॉस थीटा साइन फाई दिस टू आर द डिफरेंट. सो द नेक्स्ट स्टेप विल बी दिस वन. सो दिस इज हियर साइन a माइनस बी एंड वी नो दैट साइन a माइनस बी इक्वल टू कॉस ए इंटू साइन बी प्लस साइन ए इंटू कॉस बी. हाउ दैट देर इज नो प्रॉब्लम टू अंडरस्टैंड अप टू दिस स्टेप. सो वी कंपेयर दिस वन अकॉर्डिंग टू द जनरल इक्वेशन ऑफ ए स्ट्रेट लाइन ए एक्स प्लस बी वाई प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो. सो हियर ए इक्वल टू दिस वन साइन थीटा माइनस साइन फाइव एंड बी इक्वल टू कॉस थीटा माइनस कॉस फाइव एंड सी इक्वल टू साइन थीटा माइनस फाइव. इट इज नॉन दैट परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस डी फ्रॉम ए लाइन ए एक्स प्लस बी वाई प्लस सी इक्वल टू जीरो फ्रॉम ए पॉइंट एक्स वन वाई वन इज गिवेन बाय दिस वन. देयरफॉर द परपेंडिकुलर डिस्टेंस डी फ्रॉम द given point x1 y1 this is the 0 0 or origin is. Now putting the value of x0 or x1 0 and y1 0 then we get this step. When this one is multiplied by 0 then this is the 0. When this one is multiplied by 0 then we get this step 0. So we have only this step. So s square of this one plus s square of this one. So sine square theta sine square phi minus 2 sine theta sine phi cos square phi plus cos square theta minus 2 cos theta into cos phi. So sine square theta plus cos square theta equal to 1 and sine square phi plus cos square phi equal to 1. So this is the 1 and this is the 1 minus 2 cos we know that this one this is in the form of and we know that cos phi minus theta will be this one. So we take 1 plus 1 2 we take 2 as the common. Then in the denominator we have this one, in the numerator we have this one. So we know that 1 minus cos theta equal to 2 sine square theta by 2. So 2 to the 4 the square root of this one is 2 and a square root of sine square this one is this one. So let's see here how that there is no problem. This is the perpendicular distance of the given line from the point 0, 0. Of that there is no problem to understand the explanation of the solution of this question. If you have any doubt, write it to the comment box. I shall try my level best to clear your doubt. Join for education. Also conduct online live classes on a spot. If you want to clear your doubt then attend join online live class of Join for Education. My next video lecture will be related to solution of next questions of this miscellaneous exercise. Till then, thanks to all of you. Thank you very much.